Good afternoon to all of you. We are studying the types of strength. In earlier lecture, we have covered the angle strain. So in general, in the angle strains, all the sp3 hybridized carbon atom has the bond angle of the 1095 degree. But in case of the cycloalkanes, depend on the ring structures and number of member of the rings. As the number of member decreases, their angle strain is increases, means the deviation from the 109 increases, means as the deviation is more is angle strains.
Discomfort. Every organic molecule generally exists in different structural isomers or conformations. The relative study of stability between different conformation is referred as conformational analysis. Every conformational analysis is based on magnitude of strain or discomfort associated with the structural isomer for the given organic molecule. There are 5 different types of strains. First is van der Waals strain, second transannular strain, third is Pitzer or torsional strain, fourth is bond opposition strain, and the fifth is angle strain, that is also known as Baeyer strain. So let's talk about the van der Waals strain. Every atom in a molecule has an effective radius around it with respect to other atoms with which it is not bonded. This radius is referred as van der Waals radius. If the two such type of atoms are oriented so close to each other that the distance between them becomes less than the sum of van der Waals radii, they start repelling each other. This force of repulsion is referred as van der Waals strain. It is clear from the above discussion that the van der Waals strain will be high in magnitude in case of those molecules which possess the overcrowding of atoms. Second is transannular strain. It is also a type of van der Waals strain exhibited by two different atoms or group of atoms which are actually placed far apart from each other but oriented in such a way that due to structural position they repel each other. Such repulsive interaction is known as transannular strain. For example, in trans 1,9-dimethyl hexodecane, the two methyl groups are very close because of its cyclic structure, and that's why they start repelling each other. Next is Pitzer or torsional strain. Eclipsed conformation is found to be always less stable than corresponding staggered conformation. In eclipsed conformation, due to eclipsing interaction of different atom or group of atom, a strain is developed at the carbon atoms holding such groups. This type of strain is referred as Pitzer or torsional strain. For example, in case of ethane molecule, eclipsed conformation have hydrogen atoms very close to each other, and that's why there is strain formation over here. While in the staggered conformation, the hydrogen atoms are placed far away from each other. Thus, any deviation from the most stable staggered conformation of a molecule to the relative unstable eclipsed conformation introduces Pitzer or torsional strain in the molecule. Next is bond opposition strain. This is a type of strain or repulsive interaction exhibited by bonding pair of electrons, especially during eclipsed conformation of a molecule. Please note that Pitzer or torsional strain is because of the repulsion between the atoms, while bond opposition strain is the repulsion between the bonds. Here, the bonding pair of electrons in case of eclipsed form are closer than the staggered conformation. Thus, there will be more strain due to electron-electron repulsion. Angle strain or Baeyer strain. This type of strain arises only in cyclic compounds. The saturated carbon atoms have the normal tetrahedral angle of 109.5 degrees. When these carbon atoms form a ring, there will be deformation of the bonds, and hence it results in a deviation from the normal tetrahedral angle. Angle strain. Calculated the angle strain by assuming that all the cycloalkane rings are planar.
So the students, we have covered the all types of the strains. That is, the first is the Bayer strain. Then we have covered the Van der Waal strain. We have covered the torsional strain. Then we have studied the Bayer strain theory. So we have covered the, all this point regarding the type of the strains. If anyone is not having the notes, please message me. I will send the notes to you. Next point is the conformation of the cyclohexanes. So cyclohexane is a ring structures having the 6 carbon atom in that ring. And the cyclohexanes is a consider, if we consider the angle strain, the cyclohexanes having the negligible angle strain, so that because of this the cyclohexane is more stable, and cyclohexane can be exist in the various different forms to reduce the strains. So cyclohexane can be exist in the chair form, can be exist in the bond chair form, or in the boat form, half chair form, okay, in different forms it is exist. So cyclohexane exists in different conformation. Cyclohexane is the most stable and exists in the non-planar conformations to avoid the angle strains. In these conformations, angle strains is particularly absent, and hence they are called strainless rings. Conformations are only due to the rotation about the carbon-carbon bond of the ring. Cyclohexane molecules have two important conformations called as chair and boat conformations. They are two parallel planes containing the alternative carbon atom in the boat form. This is the boat form of the cyclohexanes. Here it is looking like the boats. On the top heads, there is a on the top heads there is a AA type, so it means it is a flagpole interaction is there. So the carbon atoms lies roughly in the planes, and the remaining two carbon are in the actual plane position on the same side by the 0.8 angstroms. Exile and the equatorial bonds. The bonds where A is written, it is called as axial bonds, and where C is written, it is called as equatorial bonds. So each carbon having the one axial bond and one equatorial bonds. So chair forms and boat forms are represented in the equatorial and axial bond form. So in the boat form, the each carbon atoms attached to the two hydrogen atoms, but all the carbon hydrogen bonds of the cyclohexanes are not equivalents. They are two sets of the 6 bonds, that is 6 carbon hydrogen bonds, which are parallel to the axis of the symmetry, which are called as axial bond, denoted by A. Remaining 6 carbon hydrogen bonds are directed at the angle of 109.28 degree to the axis of the symmetry, and they are called as equatorial bonds, indicated by the single E. Equatorial bond will be parallel to opposite carbon-carbon bonds. In the boat conformations, there are 4 boat axial bonds and 5 bonds and 2 bowsprits.
This is of cyclohexane. Cyclohexane is the most stable alicyclic ring system. The cyclohexane ring exists in the non-planar conformation to avoid the angle strain. The cyclohexane molecule has two important conformations called the chair and boat conformation. In the chair form, there are 4 carbon atoms in one plane, and the 2 opposite carbon atoms are out of plane, one above and one below the plane. In boat form, 4 carbon atoms lie in a plane and 2 carbon atoms are out of the plane, but on the same side of the plane. In chair form, there are 6 carbon hydrogen bonds which are parallel to the axis of symmetry, and they are called axial bonds, denoted by A. The remaining 6 carbon hydrogen bonds are directed at an angle of 109.5 degrees to the axis of symmetry, and they are called equatorial bonds, denoted by E. Thus, each carbon atom in chair form will be attached to one axial and one equatorial bond. And if we consider the adjacent CH bond, they are all staggered with respect to each other. Thus, the chair form is free from torsional strain and bond opposition strain. In the boat conformation, there are 4 boat axial and 4 boat equatorial bonds. Then there are 2 flagpole bonds and 2 bowsprit bonds at the carbon atom 1 and 4. But if we see along the carbon-carbon bond, then all the CH bonds are eclipsed with respect to each other. Hence, this configuration has maximum torsional and steric strain. Bonds are closer than their van der Waal radii. Therefore, there will be strong van der Waal repulsion. Thus, transannular strain is also high. In addition to chair and boat form, there are 2 more conformations of cyclohexane, the half chair and twisted boat form. The boat form is twisted such that carbon-carbon bond on the plane cross each other, and also these atoms go out of plane, and thereby the hydrogen atoms become skew with respect to each other, thus relieving the torsional and steric strain. Further, the hydrogen atoms at the flagpole bond slightly go away from each other, and thus the steric repulsion between them is decreased.
I'm going to discuss an excellent trick to draw cyclohexane chair conformations with
I will show you how to draw the cyclohexane's various structures, because it is the most important. We know that we have to draw the cyclohexane structures like a benzene. Benzene types of structure, planar structure, but we don't know that the cyclohexane structure is not a cyclohexane structure is not a planar structure. So it is a non-planar structure. So we can understand by drawing the cyclohexane structure that it is a non-planar. हमको कैसा समझ में आएगा कि ये planar में है या non-planar है? Planar means एक plane में होना. For example, consider कीजिए कि आपका blackboard. Blackboard पे जो भी सारी चीज़ें लिखी जाएंगी वो कैसी रहेंगी? Plane में रहेंगी. और एक आधा item जो है blackboard से बाहर आ रहा है तो हम उसको क्या बोलेंगे? Non-planar. Consider करिए एक table है. Table का ऊपर का जो part है, flat पार्ट जिस पे हम जो है चाय वगैरह रखते हैं, जो प्लेन सरफेस होता है वो प्लेनर है. उसके जो चार्ज जो है सपोर्टिंग जो है उसको जो एंगल लगे हुए होते हैं वो समझने का वो प्लेन से बाहर है, यानी इट इज़ नॉन प्लेनर. उसी तरह से हम इसको समझने की कोशिश करेंगे.
बाय यूजिंग दिस बॉन्ड साइक्लोहेक्सेन कन्फर्मेशंस, दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ साइक्लोहेक्सेन. Cyclohexane has 6 carbons and 12 hydrogens. It's not having a planar structure. It is having different conformations, like it has chair conformation, boat, twisted boat, half chair, like these different conformations are present. But in today's session, I am going to discuss about chair conformation of cyclohexane. Step number 1. Draw 2 parallel lines. Step number 2. Draw 2 small slant lines. First what? 2 parallel lines, then 2 small slant lines like this. Step number 3.
Hello, welcome to the
parallel lines. What is the step 3, students? Just you have to join these 2 parallel lines. That's it. You got the cyclohexane chair conformation. This is the cyclohexane chair structure. Let us see one more time. First draw two parallel lines. What is the step 2? Just draw small slant lines like this. Step number 3, just join these two parallel lines. That's it. You got the cyclohexane chair conformation. Now I'm going to teach you how to draw axial and equatorial hydrogens, because cyclohexane has total 12 hydrogens. In these 12 hydrogens, 6 hydrogens are axial hydrogens and 6 hydrogens are equatorial hydrogens. Let us see how to draw first axial. Right. See students, cyclohexane has 6 carbons. And how many hydrogens? Total 12 hydrogens. 6 hydrogens are axial hydrogens. Let us see, this is the first carbon. First carbon has hydrogen vertically upwards. Draw like this. Second carbon has hydrogen vertically downwards. Third carbon has vertically upward. Fourth carbon has vertically downward. Fifth carbon has vertically upward. And sixth carbon has vertically downward. So, what cyclohexane is having? Tell me, vertically upward, downward, upward, downward, upward, downward, like this. These 6 hydrogens are called axial hydrogens. Is it clear? Let us see the trick to draw equatorial hydrogens. This is axial hydrogens. Now, equatorial hydrogens, which is very, very important. Right. First carbon, first what you do is just give the numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. First carbon, this is the first carbon. This carbon has equatorial hydrogen. This hydrogen is just parallel to C2-C3 bond. This is very, very important. First carbon has hydrogen which is parallel to C2-C3 bond. Next. This is the fourth carbon I am taking. I'll tell you one thing. What you do is, consider C1 and C4 as one set, C2-C6 as another set, and C3-C5 carbons as one set, which is easy for you. If you do like this, it will be easy. What students? C1-C4 as one set, C2-C6 as another set, and C3-C5 as one more set. Now, C1, what I told you, C1, this carbon has hydrogen which is parallel to C2-C3 bond. And same way, C4 hydrogen is just parallel to C5-C6 bond. Like this. No need to write hydrogen. Just write like this. Next. C2. Second carbon. Hydrogen. This hydrogen is just parallel to C1-C6. Draw like this. Listen carefully. And C6. What is the next one in this second set? C6 carbon. This C6 carbon has hydrogen that is just parallel to C1-C2 bond. This is the bond. So parallel to this. What I am telling, second carbon hydrogen just parallel to C1-C6 and this carbon hydrogen parallel to C1-C2. In the same way, third set also, C3 carbon, its hydrogen is just a C5 bond like this. This bond parallel to this bond, and fifth carbon hydrogen is present parallel to this bond. This carbon bond is parallel to this bond, and this carbon hydrogen is just parallel to this one. Right? What is that? C5 is just parallel to this. For your understanding, I make a note like this. Just copy this note and practice it. Just a copy. Take rough notebook or your chemistry practicing book. Note it. Very, very important. Just note down. Later, what you have to do? This is equatorial hydrogens. What you have to do is just join these two. Actually, I'm drawing. After that, I'm drawing equatorial. Right. This is called cyclohexane chair conformation. Easy. The main thing is you have to.
In this way, you can draw the boat conformation, chair conformation also. This is a boat conformations. Here is also given the axial bond, equatorial bonds. So do the practice of this all at your homes. Definitely you can overcome all the difficulties. Thank you.